going to do an experiment on how you can test for cation and anions. And for me today, I have some materials and reagents that I'm going to use. The sun that I'm going to use to test for cations and anions that are present in this sun. A filter paper. A funnel that I'm going to use during the process of filtration. Barium nitrate in the beaker. Ammonia in the beaker. Sodium hydroxide in the beaker. The vessel indicator. I also have 4 test tubes. Then I have a test tube black. Then I also have an empty beaker and a beaker that is containing 50 ml of water. So the first step that I'm going to start with, I'm going to get this sun since I'm trying to test for the anions and I'm trying to test for the cation and anion that is present in this sun. So the first step, I'll pour my sun into the beaker that is containing 50 ml of water. Then I'll shake this paper. Then I'll get my empty paper. Then I'll fold my filter paper. And I'll put it into the funnel. So the main thing is I'm trying to do this filtration. I'm just trying to get the filtered part of the sun. Then I'll use that filtered to test for the anions and the cations that are present in the sun. So my filtrate is still being collected in the beaker, so I'll just wait for it. I'll just wait for it until it is done. It is still being collected. I think the filtrate has collected enough filtrate has collected into the beaker. So I'll divide this filtrate into the 4 test tubes. So I've just divided the filtrate into the 4 test tubes. So for the first test tube, I've added 2 cubic centimeters of the vessel indicator. Then I'll shake my test tube. As you can see, if I add 2 cubic centimeters of the vessel indicator, data in the filtered observation near and getting a green solution. So the color is filtered has turned to a green solution after adding two drops of the universal indicator. To my second test tube, I'll add two to three drops of sodium hydroxide. So if I add 2 to 3 drops of sodium hydroxide into the second test tube that is containing the filtrate, my solution in the test tube is turning to a white precipitate, or the crown mix is formed in the second test tube. Then I'll add excess of sodium hydroxide into the test tube. So if I add excess of sodium hydroxide into the test tube that I add two to three drops of sodium hydroxide, my solution in the test tube is turning to a colorless solution. To my third test tube, I'll add 2 to 3 drops of ammonia. So if I add two to three drops of ammonia into the third test tube, here my observation in the third test tube is that the crownness is formed, or the white precipitate is formed. Then I'll add excess of ammonia. If I add excess of ammonia, the test tube, I'm getting a colorless solution. So it means the white precipitate has turned to a colorless solution. Then to my fourth test tube, I'll add 2 cubic centimeters of barium nitrate. So if I add 2 cubic centimeters to the fourth test tube that is containing the filtrate, I'm getting a white precipitate. So here, using my experiment, I can use these two test tubes to say that the cation that is present in this solution is the zinc ion. If you check on the quantitative resistance step, we discover that if you add sodium hydroxide to the solution that is containing the zinc ion, at first it will turn to white precipitate, and after adding excess of sodium hydroxide to the same test tube, we discover that that solution will turn to a colorless solution. So this is what I just did to my second test tube. Then also, if you're testing for the cation, which is zinc ion, when you're using ammonia, at first on the quantitative analysis table it is written that it will turn to a white precipitate after adding ammonia to the solution that is containing the zinc ion. And if you add excess of sodium hydroxide to the same test tube, that had to turn to a white precipitate, that solution would turn to a colorless solution. So here we can say that the cation that is present in this sun is the zinc ion. Then the anion present in this sun, we can say it's the sulfate ion. This is because when you're testing for the sulfate ions, you acidify with gyrunic acid, but if sometimes you're not providing gyrunic acid, don't add it whether you add it or not, the results will be positive. And the other thing that you're supposed to do when you're testing for these sulfate ions, first of all, I've said you add diuretic acid, then you add aqueous barium nitrate. And when your observation suggests you get your white precipitate, this means that the sulfate ions are present. So me, I had to add barium nitrate and had to get a white precipitate, so I can see that the anion that is present in this sand are the sulfate ions. That's the end of this experiment. Thank you very much.